do sequencing and then depositing the data into gene bank, and then our publication could not come back until 6 months later. So again, actually showing how you can do science for public health response in order to help the response and not to be not for fame. But then we did something. Here I will be presenting things that very very. Always, I will use first, because it was really the first time we would do that in Africa. So within the few months in Africa, in West Africa, or in Sierra Leone to be specific, we're able to see and start tracking, the different variants or lineages of Ebola virus coming into the country. And you could see here around June 16, where one particular lineage, which is the SLA3 lineage, actually takes over in Sierra Leone, showing exactly. Earlier on in 2014, what we see today with the different variants, when they come in and then they take over, you see that the same with the Delta, with the Omicron and everything that we're talking about today. That was early as 2014 and how we're pioneering genomic epidemiology for public response during epidemic pandemics in Africa. We also showed clearly evidence of host-to-host transmission, and then that was what was driving, transmission in those countries. And you could see that here, identify synonymous and non-synonymous SNPs, in different populations, showing how viral evolution happened during an epidemic. But most importantly was the fact that within that period, we were able to, identify some SNPs in the genome of the Ebola virus, scattered across the genome, but I narrowed down to about 27 of them, among which, few were identified to be associated with increased transmissibility. And that, again, was the first time during an epidemic, on the African continent, and then in one of the rare in the world where you could actually use genomic as a way to show increased transmissibility of one variant over the others. So this really seminal work here in 2014, enabled us actually to identify most of these viral genomes, most of those factors that actually was driving, or sustaining the epidemic at the time. Here you could see a reconstruction whereby you could see within the space and time where we were using genomic data to show transmission, from county to county, from district to district, provinces to provinces, and then from country to country within Sierra Leone, Liberia, and Guinea. That, again, was really the first time where you could use genomic data as well to show how transmission occurred and then how public health officials could use such information to respond to an epidemic. We did not just do the genomic for the purpose of doing it, but we also translated genomic into tools that were very important to contain this epidemic. We realized during the point when that it took such a long time to do PCR, and then a lot of people that used to go to the testing centers actually went there with simple malaria but got infected because it took such a long time to collect samples and then to be tested. We realized that translating these genomic tools into point of need was actually very important. And within 4 months, we were able to translate that into developing the first point of care or point of need Ebola RDT that was approved, under emergency use authorization by the EU and then the WHO by the WHO and the US FDA. So, and this really, the introduction of this test actually in addition to other interventions on the ground, actually became a major turning point toward containing this outbreak in West Africa. But then what is important, and what I would think we would say that would have gone into the history of public health, is the fact that we're able to use, the knowledge, the skills, and then the technologies that we had in order to hide and avert what could have been one of the major health calamities in the history of mankind. That is preserving and averting an epidemic, of Ebola in Nigeria. Here you could see one of the church, a church nearby my laboratory at the time. This church had over 3 million people gathered. And it was at the time whereby we have this epidemic, and then we really have to use technology to be laser pointed and work with public health authorities in Nigeria to do again what again was something that was unprecedented. And we prevented, we did that. You could see here using genomic data and contact tracing, we worked, in a very laser surgical manner. Not only were we able to diagnose the first case in Nigeria in few hours, provided information to public health authorities, but work with them, use genomic data and other data in order to contain, to contain this pandemic. Thankfully, Nigeria came out of it, with 20 cases and 12 and 8.